Facebook, Dad.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Hormel Stadium right here in Medford, Massachusetts, as we settle in for the MLU on MLU Live. Welcome to Hormel Stadium right here at Medford, Massachusetts. The MLU on MLU Live, the Boston Whitecaps entertaining the New York Rumble. Hi, everybody. I'm Don Boyle, Tony Leonardo, alongside for the call of this one. Beautiful temperatures at about 72 degrees. Wind is light here at Medford. Something different when we come here to Medford for Ultimate Play. It's at about 4 miles per hour. Tony, and, well, key story, I think, to today's game, not the weather with a threat of rain, but how deep can these two teams go on their benches today?
Right, it is about the benches. We have 14 in uniform here for the New York Rumble, traveling up from New York on 95 there. A little bit of a haul, and players out, players injured, players not here, and it's going to be tough for them. But right on their heels, Boston with about 18 guys here, so it's going to come down to legs, freshness, and how deep your bench can go.
For Boston, they played undermanned last week at Philadelphia at St. Joseph's University. Came up on the short side, but they really did a nice job of rotating defensive guys to the offensive side of play and back and forth to try to stay fresh and made it a close game.
Yeah, exactly, and they're going to do that again today. So they did an X and Y line, so they split some of their big huckers and put them on the D line, and we'll see that again with Malachek and Marquette being on the line together, and Graham and Rebholz being on the line together.
The oddity to all that, it was the highest scoring quarter of Ultimate Play
was
all
it?
Year long,
yeah.
That game last week versus Philly. So.
Well, Philly played well. In fact, Sam Rosenthal here, Boston coach, credited Philadelphia with being a smart team. And so and smart in ultimate means that you hold on to the disc and you don't make a lot of turnovers. And last week's game was a turnover-free game for the most part. Today, anything goes.
As you can see, the Rumble coming in with a mark at 2-4. And on the flip side, Boston coming in at 3-3. They have split their season series. New York winning at home 18-17 over the Boston Whitecaps, and the Whitecaps winning the season opener right here in Medford by the score of 24-18. A game really was never in doubt as Boston dominated that season.
That's right. They've dominated here at home. And here's some of the keys to the game for Boston. Dominate downfield. Well, this shouldn't be too hard because New York are missing several of their key defensive players we know all too well. Joe Smash Anderson out for this game. Quinn Hunziker out for the season with a broken finger. And that sounds kind of simple, but I think he tore some tendons and fractured a finger very bad on a layout into the turf. Healthy. So they can dominate downfield. Control the score. Well, they win if they could keep the numbers down from getting too high of points, like the game we saw last week when they lost, and against DC where they can kind of control the score and keep it a low scoring affair. They're doing good. Healthy Graham. Jeff Graham has always been nursing an injury. We'll see how that would affect him. He never seems to show it on the field, Don. So if we ever see some signs from him when he's slowing up a little bit, we'll know they could face some trouble.
So it's just about set to get it going. On the flip side for New York, a team that's trying to stay in the playoff hunt, has it become must time for them?
Well, overcome adversity, key to the game here. Adversity being they don't have the numbers. They don't have the guys. Now they have their entire handler unit out here. As Mazur is back, Saul is here, Murphy is here, but they're missing their downfield cutters. Saul and Mazur, well, it's going to be between these guys to make it all happen. You know, it's interesting. I think the key to this game is them just taking it easy and take what comes to them. They're not going to be focused too much. They don't have a lot of guys. No first looks. This is on defense is what this means down here, the last one. They want to stop Boston from getting quick throws up the field on a stall count of one or two or three. So stop the unders quick. Get the count up high in Boston. That's how you can stop them on D.
And that was their recipe for victory versus Boston in New York. A couple of stall counts on Boston. They forced those turnovers, and they did cash in. They played a marvelous game, perhaps their best in the MLU over 2 years in that win.
So that's right.
We're just underway. That is Mazur. We nicknamed him Sir Mazur in that win over the Boston Whitecaps a few weeks ago.
He played excellent in that game, Don. He was on fire, but they had two losses to D.C. in between that time.
Let's see, our first turnover is that pass knocked away from Lucas Murphy. Couldn't dig it. And Boston trying to respond quickly. At Stevens will toss it in, and they will score. Perry Roth on the receiving end. So the D puts up a point for Boston in a 1-0 lead.
Well, unfortunate turn there from the O-line on New York. Not a way to start the game, as Murphy can't handle a pretty simple pass in the middle of the field. A little bit of pressure on him. Bobbled the pass, goes down. Roth collects the goal.
So the Whitecaps lead it just 30 seconds in. That opening pull, by the way, by Christian Foster, he helped lead a group of Boston Whitecap players today for a beautiful youth clinic that took place. So it was exciting to see that, and the young guys getting some pointers out there.
Yeah, and when we say youth, we're talking ages 8 to 12, 8 to 14, somewhere in there. Little kids running around and having a good time, and some of them look really good.
You know, they did, didn't they? Yeah. They could huck that thing.
Oh, yeah.
It was amazing.
Well, we got sons of some of these Death or Glory players here who were honored today before the game.
I wouldn't want to call them the old-timers, would you?
No. The very old-timers is what we would call them, Don.
Almost in my category, I guess.
Yeah, definitely.
Here's a short pull and another chance for the Rumble with Mazur, and they'll play it up through the middle and see if they can get anything going. That's Saul and Mazur out there together on the field. Two of the primary players for this Rumble team, and they have to drop it on back to Mazur here and see if they can get restarted. That's what Philadelphia did effectively against Boston. They swang.
Swing.
Yeah. They were able to swing it and dump it, I guess, is what I'm looking for. Two drops in a row. Murray's had that problem all year long. He dropped one again right there.
Well, this team led double the amount of drops last season as any team in the MLU, the New York Rumble, and not a good start for them.
I like the word swang. Why not? You get a lot of made-up words in this game, and there's a feed, and on the receiving end that time, Eric Stevens, and I'll tell you what, Boston off to a quick start here at home.
Well, New York looks nervous. The bus came late. It's just no excuse, but they're just not feeling it right now. Nice fake there from Roth. He really just got everybody off with that one. The young kid Roth here, this is his He's played Pro Ultimate now for three seasons. Hasn't even, I think maybe this is his first collegiate season, so he really jumped to the high levels of the game. And sometimes it takes a long time to learn good fakes like that. And that was a nice fake there, and really got his got the offense open with that fake.
Tell you what, ominous skies up above. We're scheduled to have some raindrops at about 5 o'clock, a couple of hours before the start of this game. That did not happen. Now the sky is starting to look a little bit scary up above.
Well, but the crowd, however, has been filling in here now, as we see some Exeter Andover youth players in front of us.
So Boston has jumped out to a 2-0 lead. 1 minute and 12 seconds into this opening quarter. Let's see if the Rumble with Mazur and company can settle things down. Good accurate pass to the middle. Banerjee able to control it there. And now one of the guys you really like, Brownlee, trying to see some time and get something done here for the Rumble.
Well, they wanted to put him on the O-line. He's usually a D-line handler. Here's a chance for him.
And it's knocked away. Brownlee nearly had it there. Malachek with some pretty good defense for the Whitecaps.
Malachek goes up early, distracts Brownlee. The throw is a little short from Banerjee.
Yeah, Brownlee tall and lanky.
Nice
Malachek,
play.
Yes, all the way down to Marquette, and it just drifted away and was knocked on down. Can't talk. All of a sudden, I'm making up words here left and right. What's going on?
Memorial Day weekend, Don. Long weekend ahead of us here.
Yeah, absolutely. Couple of moments in.
Wow.
Oh, Marquette with an easy steal. Rumble continues to struggle when they have the disc in hand. Not handling it well. This is Cooper. Cooper is really starting to turn up his game a notch. And another score. Malachek on the receiving end. They have made it easy.
I would call timeout here. Nunez, his team just needs to settle in here. He's putting his line back out there. They need somebody to just settle down here. They've made just mental mistakes. Just bad throwaways, drops. They're just not in it right now. And Boston making them pay. Interesting to note, Don, this game started off with the flip, and Boston won. And instead of electing to get the disc, they elected to play on D to start. So here we're looking at the turnovers. Just drop, bam. That's right in the breadbasket, both of those. Brownlee has a chance there.
Gets
the
disc. Got a hand on it, didn't he?
Got a hand on it, yeah. It was a short throw. But. And then the throw into the Marquette poach here. I mean, that's when a team's just smelling it with Boston, just like, well, hey, these guys are clearly out of their wits. You know, they're not really dialed in. There's the timeout call. Okay.
Yeah, well, much needed.
Yeah.
So 3-0 is score. Boston on top, 7:39 remaining here in the opening quarter. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more right here on MLU Live.
Come on out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnerstix.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
Right back here at Hormel Stadium. Timeout is over. Boston eagerly back onto the field. They have a 3-0 lead as they shoot some T-shirts out of some cannons into the stands here.
always fun. The kids are really going crazy. There's the youth clinic ahead of time before the game, you mentioned. And now they filled up the stands here with discs and everything. A lot of youth ultimate in Massachusetts is one of the top states in the country, if not the top state for youth ultimate. Competes with Seattle. It's like Seattle versus Boston.
Is it real?
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
See, I thought the folks here in the Northeast were always a little bit backwards. Late to find the trend, right? It all started out in the West Coast. At least, is that fashion, maybe? I don't know. Well, let's see if there's anything fashionable about the Rumble offense as they try to get something going offensively. This is Hennessy controlling. Little forehand flick up in the middle. He tried to move that disc quickly now. There'll probably be a couple of numbers I cannot identify. New players out there for New York, like number 45, hint, hint there, Tony.
That's a good question. It should be Baum. Baum was 15. Oh, that's Brenton Hard. 45 is Brenton Hard. B Hard.
And right now, long stall.
So this is tough here.
Yeah, double team will force the defense.
Quadruple team. Shuts down Hennessy.
That was
Matt
McDonald
Hennessy
knocked
it
down.
Yeah, okay, staying Big huck here.
Boston going for it all. That's Foster way out in front. He'll make the catch. Now he'll wait. And who's he going to give it to? New York trying to get back defensively. I guess they did a pretty good job because Boston now has to work to get it on in. But they do. And they take a 4-0 lead here early on the receiving end. It looked like a Henry Pressure with the catch.
Henry Brescher with the throw there. And did he get it back? Maybe he did get it back.
I thought he got it back.
Yeah. Christian Foster, who we're looking at there, number 11. His team, I believe he – well, I don't want to mess this up here. But, you know, there's a couple of big games going on today outside of the MLU, Don, and that would be the college national championships outside of Cincinnati, Ohio. And a number of players here, Christian Foster being one of them, whose team he graduated from, Carleton, just – played their pre-quarter game to make it to the next day and make it a Sunday and make it quarterfinals, and a loss for Carleton as Wisconsin takes that. There's Brescher with just an amazing rip down the field. Talking beforehand to Coach Rosenthal, he said, Brescher, we're happy to have him. He's going to play a lot. He's going to be a big guy for us. So Brescher with a happy huck there for the goal.
And you're right, it was number 11, Christian Foster, with the catch. Got to get the stats right. 4-0. I feel like I'm in a New York uniform the way the broadcast is going thus far. Major's going to send one downfield. New York trying to strike and get back into this game. The D is there, and Daugherty and company knocked it away. It turned on 2-on-1 defensively. Zid also helped out.
They're calling that a foul.
Yes, indeed, over the top.
Got him in the back. Is what they're saying on Matt Hennessy, number 10, who will pick up the disc now. Opportunity for New York.
That's a nice call by the officials. Hennessy will play it on back. Mazur will float it on in. And there's some layout there. And that time, it will count. Boy, I tell you, they have just been digging at it.
Yeah, nothing going right for New York right now.
Is that Malachek who made that play defensively? Couldn't really see the number. Now Boston in control. They lead it 4-0 here, nearly midway through this opening quarter. Brownlee with some tight defense on Malachek. That's the only way to really slow him down. Daugherty to control it now.
Well, you can't let Malachek get the pivot off, so he gets a wide open backhand.
Hey, camera one.
This is Zid.
Camera one, can you take your ND filter off?
Marquette.
Zero on that.
Had a nice
Murphy
game
with
last
the,
week.
The big mark on Zid there.
Trahey. Back into the middle now. Then Goldsmith.
Hey, Emily, camera one. Can you take that ND filter off?
Boston being a little meticulous now in their travail up the field, Tony.
Well, why not?
Good
pressure D from New York. Making them work, getting the stall count up high is one of the keys to the game. Finally, the huck comes to no one.
Like a punt.
Yeah.
Intended for Roth.
I think they just got tired of handling the disc and just threw it on that downfield.
Yeah, exactly.
You take it. Now you take it.
Let's play some defense. It might be easier. So the Rumble trying to get something going here. Down 4-0. Coming in at 2-4, New York. Boston at 3-3. You mentioned New York looked a little nervous to start the game. Why would that be?
Well, they don't traditionally win in Boston. They're short on numbers.
Another drop. They are struggling. Banerjee dropped that. He was wide open, too. That's like their fourth drop already of the quarter.
We have to get the stats keeper to find the drops to completions rate. They might be like two completions to every drop.
Malachek had a reach out from the Ingoldsmith feed, and he'll lay it in for yet another goal for Boston. They continue to just put up the numbers early, and they have opened up a 5-0 lead as on the receiving end. Good look at him, Brian Zid.
Well, great little release there from Malachek. He went to the forehand side with the back the backhand, so that's a little break marky from Malachek there. His team, Wisconsin, was the victor in the quarterfinal match against Carleton. So some mixed emotions, I'm sure, on the squads here. You see the layout there. Didn't look like it was Malachek.
That was Zid.
Zid. And so Zid there again gets rewarded. Some other scores. Our man that we saw last week here, not today, of course, Jeremy Nixon had a huge game, 7 goals for the Whitecaps last week. One of the rising stars here in the Boston area. Plays for Harvard, coached by Piers McNaughton, one of the players we saw injured here in the first week. His team, they lost in Universe Point there. Double game point, 14-13 in the pre-quarters match. And so they are out of contention, Harvard.
You talk about Nixon being a terrific player. Boy, he was fun to watch last week. So graceful.
Talk to him after the game, Don. He's a track star. He was a...
Really?
Yeah, he was going to... He had a choice between track at Harvard or ultimate, and he said, well, ultimate seems like a lot of fun. I think I'll stay with this sport.
Well,
high jumper as well.
He's got the long legs. He can certainly run. This is Mazur. Well, Mark there is able to float it on back, and let's see what they can do from this position on the field. That's Bosco. Up ahead, and no catch. Good effort. Boy, I tell you, Mazur just couldn't hold on to it, and they turn it over again to the Whitecaps.
Well, this starts to hurt if you're in New York. You know, it's just nothing is going right for you, and it's just across the board. No player has been successful at catching or making smart throws. I'm not sure what is going on here, but it starts to exponentially grind on you.
We'll see if they can pick it up defensively at least. This is McDonald.
It's almost refreshing to play D sometimes in this situation.
2:45 remaining in the quarter, and Boston already up by the tally of 5-0.
Now New York coming off two straight blowouts at the hand of D.C., so this also could factor into why they're looking a little rough around the edges here.
Of course, Boston trying to at least keep some sort of pace with D.C. They're 5-1.
Well, they play D.C. three times in the season, and the series tilts towards Boston. So two home games for Boston, so they will play D.C. here next weekend.
Ripholz and that feed a little too far ahead. And no chance for Heath to make a catch on it. And a turnover by the Whitecaps, and it's back to New York now. Bosco. They'd like to see Bosco catch on fire here today.
Now they're going to need him.
Herman to Murray. Couldn't dig it off the turf. They turn it back again. On the far side, Eric Stevens. Stevens, a player that's been much improved, hasn't he, throughout the year? He had a nice week last week against Philadelphia in that loss.
Well, Stevens was on the team last year, of course.
Here's
a feed into the end zone.
Rebholz on the receiving end. Boston with another score.
Stevens was on the team last year, and I'm not sure he was originally placed on the active roster this year. I don't remember seeing him in sort of the early games. I could be wrong there, but really definitely had a breakout last week, and you're right, three goals. And already threw a goal here today, and is a player to watch, Eric Redshirt Stevens, as we see Rebholz there with an open cut to the short corner, fed in there by Graham. Normally that connection goes the other direction with Rebholz finding somebody like Graham in the end zone, but with these mixed up lines here, it's anyone's game. And with New York giving them the disc, it's a good thing that they're playing XY here, Boston. In other words, they're not playing set O and D lines, so they're not getting tired playing six straight D points in a row now, which is a little uncommon,
really,
I'd say.
Is.
But we might be setting records again in terms of, I don't know, straight number of deep defensive points. Play. Well, D.C., I think, might have gone on a six-goal run against New York 2 weeks ago
two weeks ago.
So maybe not.
Well, let's see what the Rumble can do this time around. They've had all sorts of problems trying to at least find some continuity on the O-line. This is Hennessy.
This is the point where their coach has just got to start getting angry.
Pass, far side. Nice catch here by Hennessy on a low throw. Nearly inside that goal line. Oh, looks like he got over-anxious and throws it up and allows the D to come on over and just swat it away. Once again, I think he was getting a little worried about that stall time there.
Yeah, the count got up high. He's looked, Hennessy, that's Matt Hennessy, looking around, asking where his cutters are, as there was only one person isolated in the end zone, covered by two defenders. So he had a legitimate gripe with his team not coming back to the disc for him.
Haven't mentioned Danny Clark again out of uniform today for the Whitecaps. Didn't play last week either. Well, they turn it over to the Whitecaps, and here's a chance. And they'll have to restart here, looking again as Banerjee.
Well, they're not looking good.
And this time they'll make the catch for their first score on the receiving end was Evan Walter.
Well, Walter there collects the first score for New York, fitting perhaps as the new guy coming in from CHS, Columbia High School there in Maplewood, New Jersey, and makes his debut here in the MLU this weekend, collects the first score for the New York Rumble as they finally get on the board.
6-1 your score, 31 seconds remaining.
Well, it only took 9 minutes, 9.5 minutes for New York to score, but they did get a score. Saul here feeds it with a pretty forehand up high.
With threatening skies up above, maybe the Rumble threatening to get back into this contest here in the opening quarter. Long road to haul, however.
Well, now they get a chance on D, at least, to try to change the mentality a little bit here.
Mazur on the pull.
Change the perspective.
Marquette able to play it up ahead. York hoping to get back into it. Graham to the near side, wants someone to go deep. Now he just dumps it on back. Graham's been playing back a couple rows, not up front as a cutter as we've seen him in the past last year when he would chase down Hudson, make sensational catches. A little injured here. That throw precisely done. And a great catch there by Steven as he anticipated it beautifully. And another point up on the board.
Well, what timing. What an amazing, that looked like a disc golf throw from Henry Brescher there. He sent that up with a beautiful little touch on it. Just flowed that up nicely high, past two defenders to the back of the end zone there where only Stevens could get to the disc. Amazing release. Not sure how he got that throw off to be so beautiful. Just a beautiful float there. No chance for Brenton Hart. Stevens with the disc in his hands for the goal.
It was run by Stevens. Didn't overrun it, wasn't anxious. Very patient waiting for that beautiful throw. His second goal of the game.
Oh, it's easy when it comes in that nice, Don.
Oh, for you, maybe. You wanted to suit up earlier today. I heard you talking
about it. I thought I could help out the New York team.
That would have been fun.
I would get killed out there. I would probably make it worse. I don't know how that's quite possible. Here's a chance now for New York.
Going to hang up there, and it's going to be caught and intercepted. And the Whitecaps with a very successful
Miles.
Opening quarter on the receiving end with Miles Montgomery Butler ending any threat.
Well, there's the end of your first quarter, folks. It's 7-1 Boston, as you see here. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Come on out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnersticks.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
Right back here at Hormel Stadium, 7-1 through one quarter play. The Whitecaps leading the Rumble. You're watching MLU Live. Tony Leonardo, Don Boyle alongside here. Memorial Day weekend, and of course, it's a great weekend in celebration to remember our fallen soldiers that have made us a free country, the country we are today, Tony.
So. Sure. Both my grandfathers were in World War II, so we do always appreciate Memorial Day. And although they made it through, not everyone makes it through. And we do want to remember that.
Right now, the Whitecaps have it all their own way here at home at Hormel Stadium. 7-1 lead. And really, they didn't have to do too much to build a six-goal lead.
Well, Tell that to Brusher, at least, though. He's making it look nice out there. He's put up two beautiful throws. But you're right. They've been handed the disc, and when they've gotten the disc, have known what to do with it, which is get it into the end zone for easy scores.
Some of the pregame notes I was reading, it said Mazur saw handle conservatively today. Are they doing that, and is that getting them into trouble?
You know, it's really tough to say that there's trouble out of the handle position, right? Because they haven't had any flow, and they've been dropping the disc. Yeah, exactly. So it's like, how do you say? I mean, everyone's dropped. Right, I count Matt Hennessy with two turnovers. Both times he was trapped. They got to recognize they're being trapped on the end zone. He had four guys on him last time, and he had two down here. I had two guys with two drops. I've got Austin Raymond, I think, had two. Murray had two. So, you know, just this kind of action. Banerjee had two as well early on. So there's just no rhythm right now for these guys.
Just about set to get the second quarter going. Whitecaps will receive the pull. Brownlee to send the pull downfield. As the Rumble trying to get back into this game. So a late goal in the quarter perhaps has given them some energy. They scored 9:29 into the opening quarter, their only point up on the board. And let's see what Boston can do. Rebholz, a terrific player. Malachek, of course, we all know what he can do. He did have a very good game the last time these two teams played, however, in New York. He struggled a bit, remember?
Yeah, Joe Anderson on him. Anderson not here today. Brownlee rips it out of the sky.
That is a great defense. Terrific play against a very good Jimmy Foster. He just took it away.
He did.
And now they just plain old drop it again. That time was Hennessy. Hennessy's had the dropsies today a couple of times now. Brusher played it near side. Malachek will feather it down the sideline and in for the score. And they are just making him pay. Malachek on the receiving end was out. I can't pick up the number. It looked like Graham, number 21 Graham.
Yeah, Jeff Graham there gets the goal. Nice feed from Malachek there. One thing that happens, Don, is when a team gets the drops, you might think it might affect the other squad where it's kind of like, well, you know, it's like they're giving us the game. You know, do we not compete? Boston's still competing hard out here. Like these type of throws that Malachek just threw there, like you have to be focused 100% to make a perfect throw like that. It's an easy look. It looks like down the line, forehand throw, open side. But the touch he has to put on that to zip that in just enough, not sail it out of bounds. So it means that they're maintaining their focus, Boston here, and that just spells more trouble for New York.
This is that Brownlee defensive play. That was spectacular. He just stole it.
Went up early. I like that play from Brownlee. Big bid there from Walter. Malachek takes his time and puts just a little nice under on it to float up there to Graham.
You know what I liked about that replay? It showed how spectacular his vision is. He saw Graham out of the corner of his eye as he was making that catch, and no doubt about the feed.
And he saw he kind of put a little underneath it. Yeah. It was a hot shot, but he like let it rise up a little bit from down low.
Great touch. All right, New York again. Been a little bit of a circus act today when they've handled the disc. Bosco. Let's see what he can do. Stall. That's an intercept by Cooper. That was just easy pickings again. They really force to just throw it up there.
Well, I'm not sure what their offense is doing, but needs to regroup.
And Goldsmith. Here comes a hammer. And Roth will make the catch.
Well, nice. Looking for the flip. Is he going to do it? Terry Roth there. A little tired after that run all the way across the field. And he has a no backflip after hammer catch rule. I don't know if you knew that, Don. But nice throw there from Ingold Smith as Roth collects the goal. There's the flip. Timing was off there. Bosco and Mazur. Bosco puts it up tied where he think Mazur might float to. You see Rusty there. Rusty and Goldsmith sort of nods to Roth on that one. He get a little head shake. He was like, left. Roth saw him, whipped over to left-hand side there. That would be Ingold Smith's left. And with the forehand force, Ingold Smith with the hammer over the top for the goal.
Boy, that looked like a pitching motion the way he threw that hammer. He might play for the Red Sox the way they're going.
I've seen players that played, a famous player from played with the Los Angeles team for a number of years, the Condors, Tara Ramberg, who played, was a pitcher in college in Vermont.
Yeah. Okay.
And so his hammer throws were rather unique. The pitching motion and everything, and they came in really fast and short and like low.
See, there is a place for a baseball pitcher after baseball.
That's right. Get out here.
This is Raymond. Murphy played it around. Brownlee seeing more time today, obviously, than we've seen in others. And this is Hennessy. He'll make the catch from Brownlee.
Well, nice feed there. Right to recognize a little poachy D from Boston. Find the space. Brownlee able to feed Hennessy into the end zone. Hennessy wise enough to go all the way there, too, without the Boston D being present. Nice little touch on this. Just sails it up neatly. And the goal.
So they cut the gap to 9-2.
As they hurry off the field, and this is a little bit risky here as the clock will be their enemy as they rush a new line on to play defense for New York. We got Dan Heyman out there, Murray, Hennessy. Here's the O line now for the XY line, so they're just splitting up. They're not playing a strict offense and D line. They're missing some of their D players. Teddy Bauer-Jarris not here. John Hershberger not here. Reinhardt not here. Robin Myers not here. Some big Hatchett is not here this weekend. So a lot of D players missing for Boston. So that forced them to just switch the lines all the way up, and we're seeing different mixes all over the place.
With Raymond on the pull, and Boston now on the attack. Malachek in the middle of the field. Boston gets the disc to the middle of the field to get their play started to become so dangerous. We have an injured New York Rumble, and I believe that is Michael Hennessy that got banged up a little bit. I don't know if he just lost his footing or if there was a bit of a collision away from the disc, but he's limping over towards the sideline.
Let's hope it's just a low ankle sprain or maybe a little bit of turf toe. Hope he's all right there. Ice that down. We'll see if he comes back in the game or not.
They have a great medical staff on hand here at Hormel Stadium in Medford. So we'll get a restart. Marquette, sideline left, Doherty. Zid skidding to a stop on his knees. Lucky he's wearing those leggings under the shorts there.
Smart on this turf, although the turf is pretty forgiving.
Montgomery, Butler's pass, intended for Malachek, goes awry, and they turn it over here to New York.
A little bit of wind here now, not too bad. You can see it on their jerseys on the field here. Might have affected Montgomery Butler's release point or his touch on that throw.
Mazur. He'll try to find a way to get the Rumble back into this game. Heyman. Try to get it back into the middle, and they throw it away again. That pass is intended for Isaac Saul, and Whitecaps with a quick score. Didn't have to travel too far to score that one. Malachek, good look at him.
Well, not much to say here. Just simple turnovers here. The mental focus of this team is not all there at this moment right now for New York. It's pretty obvious. Little dump pass there from Heyman doesn't work. We see some of the kids here with their white caps goods on. Good crowd here today, Memorial Day weekend. The Saturday, of course. Some of the scores from Nationals, if you're tuning in, if you haven't already seen them. As, again, Carlton down to Wisconsin in a North-Central rematch.
Upsets, Tony, out of all this grouping that you're seeing?
Yeah, actually, I guess it's not an upset. Texas takes out Central Florida. Central Florida was in the finals last year, and they lose in pre-quarters this year. But they had a tough road to get here and were already matched up down low at a 14 seed. So I guess the big news is actually Harvard. Well, Harvard gets there too, so nothing major yet. Wisco, Wisconsin, this is a 12 seed in the quarters, but this is a team that's won it a bunch. So to me, that's not an upset.
Let's see what New York can do. Continue the struggle as they bring it back into the middle of the field. Baum. Been hard to describe their play thus far. That's Mr. Hart controlling it. It was well guarded there by McDonald, who's hustling all over. Whitecaps have really turned up the heat here defensively, understanding that the Rumble just can't handle all the confusion.
Nice play by Hennessy to maintain possession. Breaks the mark nicely. There's a forehand flick. Will it hang there to the back line? And
yes,
they get the score. Mr. Hard with a beautiful catch on the back line.
Brenton Hard goes up nicely for this. Takes a look down at his feet. Sees where the line is first and then goes up high. Hangs there for a little moment and collects the goal. Nicely done, Brenton Hard. Watch this one. It looks like it's going to travel too far. The Banerjee got a little I.O. flick. It's going to hang up there just enough. Looks down quickly, goes up, and just keeps his feet down there nicely. Both feet in for the goal.
Well, certainly New York needed that. They cut it to 10-3 with 6:38 remaining till halftime. At halftime, Jeff Snader's going to join us, the commissioner of the MLU, to talk about the upcoming championship game, a shift of date and time. That's all I'm going to tell you. You got to tune into the interview at the half. How's that for a tease?
That's a heck of a tease.
You're going to hang around for that now, aren't you?
I will.
Good look at Boston.
Farnsworth, Marquette. We saw Christian Foster in there. He looks angry.
So you're up by seven. You're still in the first half. Do you start to go in some sort of a maintenance role now, up by seven if you're Boston, or you still put down the pedal to the metal, so to speak, as we get a whistle?
You know, different teams do it differently. Some teams' focus is, you know, we just will keep the gas on the whole time.
Yeah.
You know, and you see that in all the other sports, too. And some teams will start to soften up a little bit, you know, save the intensity for later on when you want to use it, you know.
Right now, Boston looks like they're going straight up the field, trying to put up another point. Malachek's going to flick one on in. That was a great throw again, wasn't it? Doherty on the receiving end. I like the little fake on the backhand side, and then that was beautiful.
I mean, he just has it. I mean, just his release point and the way he gets these throws off is magnificent. Just he's able to sail it in from a point where you think he's not going to release it. So right there, you can see his snap down afterwards. So he releases and just snaps down on his hand and is able to get the nice touch on it.
So Boston puts up another point. That is the first goal for Doherty today. I got Malachek for two assists already. Probably has more than that, three. Indeed he does.
Three assists,
couple of goals already today.
So he's eclipsed New York alone so far. There you see Walter Murphy, Brenton Hard, number 45, Banerjee, number 33 for New York. As this shorthanded squad isn't helping themselves out much with the drops and the turnovers.
Foster on the pull, and now the Rumble with a chance with 6 minutes remaining till halftime. Trying to get something going, down by eight. They trailed by six to end the first quarter, so it has not gotten any better here in quarter number two as of yet. There's time. This is Raymond. Murphy. Baum.
Oh, he had that, too.
Finds Hennessy. He thought he was going to go long.
He had an open man.
Energy. Had to drop it on back. They drop it. They're not swinging it around. Not reversing too much direction. A little flat-footed, in my estimation, and I guess layman terms. And that would have been a difficult catch, but a catchable disc, and they just couldn't bring it down. Handcuffed him just a little bit.
It's a good way to put it, Don. Kind of had a choice there. The wrong choice, however, was made. He didn't have anybody behind him, so he didn't need to go up early, did Raymond. The disc took him a little bit off his mark and not able to come down clean with it.
So now Boston, after yet another drop. This time they'll huck it all the way down, and that's some layout defense. That is terrific, terrific work by Brenton Hart. Nice job.
Brenton Hart there showing up today. He was here early. Drove up for the weekend yesterday. And the fresh legs, it looks like, is helping out his game. Nice D there.
Absolutely.
Way to be in position, really. It's about half the game is about positioning, and he was in the right place.
Jim Foster thought he had one. Now, Banerjee intercepted by Christian Foster. Another turnover. Either they drop them or they throw it away here in the first half. Result down by eight. Get a whistle. We're going to get a timeout. Yep. Whitecaps calling a timeout here. I believe. Looks like the Whitecaps coming out to chat as a group. We do have a timeout. All right, we'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more right here on MLU Live.
Come on out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnerstix.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
All right, welcome right back here to Hormel Stadium. Tony Leonardo, Don Boyle. We're in the second quarter. It's all Whitecaps here today, 11-3 over the New York Rumble. Rumble having all sorts of problems, just not going their way at all. And Boston's made it look easy.
Boston's had it easy. It's a good look at Tom Matthews, Danny Clark there. Tom Matthews, who played with Death or Glory there with the Puma jersey in your center there, the offensive line coach for this Boston Whitecaps team.
Danny Clark, I was talking to Danny after the game last week, and he goes, you know, that camera was in my face on the sideline all the time. I didn't know what to do because he wasn't in uniform,
yeah.
And he looked like a coach we had mentioned.
He looks like a coach today, yeah. Too, doesn't he? Yeah.
He looks more comfortable now in front of the camera after a week's experience.
I think he's ill today. He's nursing a cold, Clark.
You can tell he loves his team. He's here every week, whether in uniform, obviously, or not. More points up on the board as Graham on the receiving end again. It is 12-3 Boston.
Well, fun times for Boston here. These guys are, it's just almost like playing a scrimmage at this point. So it's just kind of fun. You know, trying to pad your stats or something. Not sure. There's a lot of action here that you could think about doing here. Just either you're going to like play, you know. So sometimes you'll play a game left-handed.
Right.
Like non-dominant
right.
Hand.
Yeah, right, exactly.
So when we start seeing that, then, then the beers will be out, and then everything gets a little wacky. But hopefully we won't see that.
I do see one umbrella out. I don't know if that's good news or bad news.
Good news for New York. It was a rain delay or maybe a rain cancellation might allow them to escape back to New York. Rusty Ingold-Smith here for the pool for Boston as New York will again give it a shot.
Third meeting of the year between the two. They did split. Boston winning here at home, New York at home.
And they have one more to go in New York.
This is Hennessy. Good to see him back in the lineup. He hobbled off the field earlier, and he'll hammer one. Nice little touch that to edge it into Brownlee.
That's right.
Good play by Brownlee there to throw it under the break. Well, Lamarck, actually, right? He did a nice job.
Yeah, he's got an interesting release, this Brownlee. There he goes again.
This is the most continuity we've seen out of the Rumble. Can he get it? No. Sorry, I jinxed it. Michael Hennessy couldn't catch up to the feed.
Yeah, a little hot there. You could see on the release that it didn't have the air underneath it to hang. And definitely a hot shot there for Hennessy, and he's not able to track it down. It's Ingold-Smith again will pick up the disc.
You do that to a guy that hobbled off the field.
Yeah, why?
It's earlier, right? Make him run like that.
Give him a break.
Absolutely. So the Whitecaps will regain control on yet another turnover. Thomas Cooper. That's Stevens. He's quickly becoming one of my favorite. Now it's down the Roth. There was a collision there. Will they rule incomplete?
Clean D there by Murray. Roth came crushing into him, trying to get back to the disc.
Murray up, limping a little. I'm going to try to turn that around the defense. Nice little flight to the disc. That was Hennessy.
Oh, finally a good look here.
Yeah, that's Murray, and he'll catch it with Roth in coverage. That was a nice throw by Heyman to set it all up. Now Murray.
Their end zone offense needs work.
And they're going to call a stall.
Oh, man, that is too bad. I thought he still had another second on there. Unfortunate turnover, and they're coming in droves now for New York in just about every way imaginable.
Yeah, what else is left?
I think they still have another timeout left. They do have a timeout left in the half, and real mistake there not to call it.
This is Doherty, sideline. Stevens. Ooh. He'll play one all the way downfield, and No chance there for McDonald to get to that. Matthew Rowan McDonald. Oh, they call him Rowan, right? You have all the inside scoop.
Not a Rowan. He's relatively new to the game. I believe this is his third or fourth year. They love his athleticism.
How bad is the rating out there?
Okay. Again, the rumble. Trying to stretch the field here a little bit. And Murray going up, and Brownlee there too, and neither one could come down. You had three white caps in defensive position, including in Goldsmith.
Well, he certainly got up there, had a hand on it, couldn't come down with it.
Got 1:18 remaining till halftime, and so, we're going to get a timeout.
So Boston calls a timeout, but New York, that entire possession, doesn't? I don't understand. There's Murray. Times it nicely. Waits for Stevens. Oh, interesting.
A little bit.
He was clean. It just came up short. Where Murray's hand was, the disc hit him in the wrist. So interesting. He went up, I guess, maybe late, and Stevens was there for it.
So we have a timeout with a timeout. We'll step aside. Back with more on MLU Live. It's the Whitecaps on top of the Rumble.
Come on out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnerstix.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
Back, as you can see, I guess we're going to be back in Philadelphia on June 15th, which I believe is a Sunday. Looking forward to that at St. Joseph's University. Oh. We were there last week, right?
Yeah.
That was great take. They put on a great show, very entertaining, and it's great to hear that we're heading back to the grand city of Philadelphia.
Beautiful field, great crowd out there. The Mad Beats drumline was there. Dizzy the Dog was there.
Dizzy the Dog made me dizzy.
And thence the name.
He spins around a lot. This is Marquette. Of course, at halftime, we'll talk to the commissioner of the MLU. Joining us will be Jeff Snader, talking about an outstanding facility that they're going to use for their championship game on July 19th. That's all I'm going to tell you. Another tease. That's going to hang. Tipped and deflected away. Skying forward, Austin Raymond just couldn't come up with it.
Well, Baum put that up and shook his head and was disappointed at it. It ended up being in the perfect position for Raymond, but he cannot come down with it. Whoa!
Wow, that just slapped right in the face of Evan Walter, who had a goal earlier for New York. No way he's going to catch that. Like he didn't take his teeth up.
Well, New York is about to end this half without calling a timeout. So they're going to lose one here with 18 seconds left, which is just, I don't know what's going on.
Matt Hennessy will play one up, really, and that's uncatchable. Had some rise to it and floated. They're going to call contact, however, on Boston, and New York's going to get it back. Just yards.
Well, now they have to call a timeout, and hopefully they do, and I think they do here. They don't have to call a timeout, but it sure would be intelligent, wouldn't it?
The second time they've been down by the goal line. It was a stall count that went against them when they didn't call that timeout you were looking for earlier. Well, Hennessy, the feed, and they have the score. Well, on the receiving end, his second.
Boston came down there, and they had success with this earlier, but this time ineffective with a four-person cup there to try to just really pressure the thrower right from the beginning. And once it's broken, it's not a problem. You swing, and you got an open man or two in that case right there.
So 12-4, you score. Boy, we went nearly 4 minutes without a point being scored.
Yeah, and the last, and all without a timeout being called by New York either. But they get the score, so it works.
So they're down by eight. They can make their adjustments at the half. Try to come out and do a little bit better in the second half.
Well, you know, you just got to, like, you got to look each other in the eye and say, do we want to play? Do we want to be here?
Or
do we not want to be here? And I really hope that they say, we want to play, and let's get it on, you know.
Mazur with the pull. Boston with a chance with their throwers. Never in dull moment. Graham.
A lot of rain, a little bit of rain coming down now.
They set that up nicely for the huck downfield by Christian Foster into a maze of plays, and it's caught for the score. What a play by Eric Stevens.
Unbelievable red shirt Stevens there earns his stripes with a beautiful tip disc drill as he lays out in the rain for the goal to end the half.
That's the third of the game, and was grand for Stevens. Told you he's becoming one of my favorite.
Way to stay with it. Stay on your feet there. It gets tipped by Brownlee up in the air there and thought he got just enough of it, but not enough as Stevens alertly goes down to the turf to grab it.
So Boston ends the first half in style. 13-4 the lead over New York. We'll take a break. We'll be back with our halftime. Jeff Snyder's going to join us, so stay tuned for all that right here on MLU Live.
Brendan Wong hopes to continue his scoring frenzy as the Nighthawks fly south to Seattle, but Donnie Clark and the potent Rainmaker offense stand in their way. Come out and bring the family May 31st at 7 p.m. Evan Boucher and the Dogfish hope to stay in the playoff hunt when they travel north to Portland, but Eli Friedman and the Stags try to get their season back on track. San Francisco at Portland, May 31st at 6 p.m.
Right back here at Hormel Stadium, you can see the halftime scores, all Boston 13-4 over New York. A bit of the dropsies in the first half, the turnovers, the count went too high for me to remember for New York, really being a little crazy about it all. But in all actuality, they had problems holding on to that disc in every way you can as we take a look at some of the first half highlights.
Well, the highlights are going to be all Boston. Big layout there from Zid there. But Walter Evan Walter scores New York's first point there. Brownlee goes up early and snags the disc out of the air for a snack from Foster. Ingold Smith there shakes his man off, tells him to go to the left side, and Roth collects the goal. Banerjee puts this one up for Behar. Looks down quickly, goes up, hangs, and comes down with the goal.
That's a great catch, great awareness.
Brent Hard didn't start the season with this team, but made the roster, and they're glad to have him. Here's another big put from Brusher, but this one gets deed up by Brenton Hard again.
We were talking about how badly New York played, but we're seeing a lot of their positive highlights
Yeah.
here. What's that guy talking about, they're probably saying?
Here's the end of the game. You see Brownlee misdirect the disc, tips it, and Stevens with the grab.
Yeah, all Boston. 13-4 is your score. Obviously, New York with a few highlights in the first half. Eric Stevens with that catch, his third goal of the game. Let's talk about this rising star for a moment, and then we'll try to translate it all into what New York needs to do to stop guys like Stevens here in the second half.
Well, what do? You catch the disc, and you tell your team, guys, do it for your teammate, and you also got to mix up the offense. I mean, I've seen them do some different things, but you got to go back to the basics. You got to the fundamentals. Coach Nunez told me at the beginning of the season, he said, I don't tolerate fundamental mistakes, and right now he's tolerating them because either he has to or he's not getting the message through to his team that these mistakes can't happen. So fundamentals.
We're going to take a break. When we return, going to talk to the commissioner of the MLU, Jeff Snyder, pre-recorded interview prior to the start of the game, so we'll have that all coming your way. That's coming up after this commercial break on MLU Live.
out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnerstix.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
Welcome right back here to Hormel Stadium. Again, you have time score 13-4. Starting to rain here in Medford, Massachusetts, as it usually does, Tony. I don't know if it's going to add any time to the halftime clock at all, but a lot of folks are scurrying for some cover. No lightning. That's the good news. That means an automatic delay in the start of the second half here. Went through that a couple weeks ago right here in Medford with a big thunderstorm coming through in the night in which the Bruins beat the Montreal Canadiens. So, some good things happen here in the Boston area, I guess, hockey fans. But we're going to go to that interview now, pre-recorded with the commissioner of the MLU. Jeff Snyder joins us talking about the upcoming championship.
Joined by Jeff Snyder, of course, the commissioner of the MLU. And, well, Jeff, I know you're all excited about July 19th. PPL Park is going to host the championship game of the MLU.
I'm very excited. You're right, July 19th. Seems like it's been a long time coming. We get to be in a big pro park right on the riverfront, so it's going to be pretty exciting, Don.
Major League Soccer plays there with the Philadelphia Union. Should be outstanding when you play in a major league park like that. And, you know, talk about the amenities of PPL Park.
Well, it's incredible because we've really never been in a stadium like that, and I've never even seen an Ultimate Frisbee game that's been in a stadium like that. So there's club box suites, and there's reserved seating, and there's sideline seatings, and there's beautiful grass that'll be painted just for our field, and there's a whole club section that seats 200 people that'll have all sorts of food and drinks there. So it's going to have like a real feel, like it's our event. So, I mean, it's kind of like a dream come true. So I guess we'll see what happens when we get there.
It holds 18,000 people plus, too. So if
we'll
you get that many folks, absolutely, that'd be great. Talk about the marketing game plan to bring the people to the park.
I mean, one of the first things, and, you know, Nick and I just did a podcast this week, and we were telling people, we want you out there. Like, we need your help. Everybody who loves Ultimate Frisbee, come to this game. It's going to be incredible. It's going to be incredible feel and the way the whole thing's put together and the amount of work the crew's doing. I'm so proud of them. But come out and let's have a huge celebration of, like, you know, all that's happened. And then for all the people that are new, you know, we've touched so many new demographics. So we want to pull as many of them out and just say, come and see what this game is like, you know, in the big stadium. The big times.
One of the things the MLU has done a terrific job of is having clinics for the youth. You had one prior to the game that we're going to witness here, and of course you'll have one prior to the start of the championship game.
Yeah, we're going to have a lot of them. First, I want to say the Whitecaps did an incredible job at this pregame clinic, and Christian Foster was amazing, so I'll give a shout-out to him. Yeah, the spinner staff, they'll be out giving clinics to kids. There's a huge field and fields outside of PPL Park. There's going to be all sorts of stuff going on. I mean, it's literally going to be a party for the entire day.
Take us back. How did it all come together for you? Last year was Franklin Field, which is a great location in Philadelphia, and now this new location.
And we were set to do Franklin Field again, which is, you know, I love that venue. It would always have a dear place in my heart. But PPL ended up contacting us and saying, you know what, what if we held it on the 19th? And they were actually motivated to get us to switch. And that was a cool feeling. And when we sat down and talked to them and they said, come to the stadium. And Dom, when you walk on the field, you're sold. You know, I mean, that every blade of grass sticks up just perfectly like it wants you there. So it was, it was meant to be.
How about grass field instead of these turf fields that we see these guys play on most of the time?
I know the players are going to like that more. Grass is just it's just better in every single way. And I think, you know, when you talk about field grooming for a pro level stadium, there's nothing better. So it's going to be great for everybody.
Also, great roof covering in case it rains, but it never rains on an MLU championship day.
Look, I bring warm weather and sun, okay? Look at it right now, okay? So that's what I do. So it should, if I'm staying with the consistency, it'll be a perfect day.
I'm looking forward to it. It should be terrific. How can people pick up tickets? How can they stay in touch with the MLU and find out more information?
Yeah, so number one thing is go to MLUchampionship.com and then get all the information there. It'll take them to buy tickets, which is through the Philadelphia Union site. They can see all the different types of seating that's out there, and they'll get all the updates on MLUchampionship.com that they need to know you know, who to, or how to book tickets, and what are the best like packages for them. There's group packages, all sorts of stuff. And if they have any questions, you can always shoot an email to info@mlultimate.com or tickets@mlultimate.com. Somebody will get right back to you and let you know.
And I don't think you have to worry about a hotel room in Philadelphia. I mean, if you're coming from the West Coast to follow the championship team from the Western Division, or you're a casual fan wanting to come out and enjoy just a grand city, I'm sure you can find a hotel pretty easily.
And we'll have hotel deals. So if you want those deals, and I actually think they might be posted on the site already. If not, they'll be there soon. But if you have any questions, info@mlultimate.com. People will give you all the information around, help you book tickets, show you all the discounts, anything you need.
Great. Jeff, thanks for joining us.
Oh, thank you, Don. You know you're my favorite.
All right. Jeff Snyder joining us, of course. Great job. The commissioner of the MLU. And pick up those tickets. Check it all out.
So there you go, Jeff joining us. Pre-recorded, of course, when the weather was gorgeous here in Medford, Massachusetts, here at halftime. It is now raining. I don't know if it's going to mean a delay to the start here, Tony, the second half, trying to get word on that. But the scoreboard is not working now here at Hormel Stadium. We know that. No lightning, at least we haven't seen any. But Boston has certainly put up some big waves in the first half of the Whitecaps, haven't they, in the lead here?
Well, they've just rode the wave of drop seas from New York. So, yeah, disappointing so far from New York. You know, last time when it rained at, around the half, New York, Boston, New York came out and kind of made some action happen. Yeah. So, you know, maybe they're in and Isaac Saul actually wrote a pretty interesting piece there for his team on his blog about how the rain at halftime really brought his team together and they bonded and said, listen, guys, let's go out and get it. So they'll hope for a repeat halftime speech before they get out of this field. You can hear the fans out there cheering their team as the Whitecaps start to take the field as Jeff Graham there runs out.
So I guess that answers the question, will there be a delay? There will not. Obviously, I was talking to Jeff about the championship game July 19th in Philadelphia. PPL Park should be terrific. You know, Philadelphia Union play soccer there. It's going to be lined without the football numbers and all that, just for the game of Ultimate. How excited are you about that venue?
Well, I hope it brings back memories of watching Team USA play Team Japan and Team Canada at the Cali Football Stadium in Cali, Colombia, which is one of the top, you know, soccer stadiums there in the country, and the Colombianos really like soccer. So that was a beautiful park. So we're looking forward to, I'm looking forward to some of that action there. Some beautiful, beautiful fields and just a great facility.
Certainly too much time to predict, too much season left to predict who the two opponents will be in that championship
Not really.
Game.
Yeah. New York and Boston.
You think so? You think so? No, it can't be that New York and Boston.
Losing my mind because it's on here.
You got to give me one West Coast.
The finals. Yeah. Well, it's not New York anyway. I'm in Boston and D.C., of course. Ooh, prediction. Well, that's a tough one.
I'll give you another week. You can think about that for one more week.
Well, let's see what happens today. As Portland gets on their bus up to Vancouver.
Didn't they have some problems with that bus trip?
I heard they did have some problems that they were hooked up from Enterprise, I guess, as their bus broke down and they got rental cars to get to Vancouver.
Rebecca McClellan, if I'm pronouncing her last name correctly, was a savior, I guess.
Savior of the Portland Stags.
Yeah.
Only if they win the game.
Yeah, right.
If they lose the game, maybe they will have regret going up at all to Vancouver. Although Vancouver, a nice town, why not?
Well, you can see the folks trying to scurry back into their positioning in the stands, huddled under umbrellas and alike. The players out there, some under some sort of rain gear in the white caps, and the officials just, well, they're just tough. They're out there just feeling the rain. Getting ready for the second half of MLU on MLU Live. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the second half. Boston in command over New York.
Brendan Wong hopes to continue his scoring frenzy as the Nighthawks fly south to Seattle, but Donnie Clark and the potent Rainmaker offense stand in their way. Come out and bring the family May 31st at 7 p.m. Evan Boucher and the Dogfish hope to stay in the playoff hunt when they travel north to Portland, but Eli Friedman and the Stags try to get their season back on track. San Francisco at Portland, May 31st at 6 p.m.
Friction Gloves is the official glove provider of the MLU. These all-weather gloves are specially designed for ultimate players, combining the tackiness of receiver gloves with a rubberized grip for better catches and throws. Look for the Friction Gloves Catch of the Week throughout the season and get an official MLU pair for yourself from the MLU shop. Visit frictiongloves.com to learn more.
All right, Friction Gloves. Have we had a Friction Glove Catch of the Week yet today?
That Stevens catch at the end was pretty nice, wasn't it?
It was, absolutely. He is quickly turning into my favorite. With Danny Clark out of the lineup now for the Boston Whitecaps, he's starting to become my guy. I mean,
have you talked to Danny about
Danny's
this?
Danny's becoming old school. He's got to get back in the lineup there for the Whitecaps.
He looked miserable on the bench. He's not happy to not be playing.
No, he wants to be out there. Of course, you want to see all teams healthy and fully staffed when they come on out to play. Isn't both teams a little bit on demand
he's
today.
Out there throwing
in
the rain.
Yes, he is.
It's pouring rain. Yeah. Danny Clark isn't suited up. And he's out there.
And who's he throwing to?
He's throwing to Eric Richard Stevens.
That's right, my new guy. So, there you go.
Got his nickname by missing a year of college and keeping his fifth year of eligibility. Graham
You know, how about the different role that Jeff Graham's played a little bit this year? You know, it's because of his injury to his knee, he's changed his tactics a little bit out in the field, and maybe you can explain that to some of the folks that are looking for Graham to make all these highlight catches week in and week out.
Well, in this game, you don't need him to, and it's the type of player he doesn't have the youth that he once had. Still has the nickname Grasshopper because he does get up, but why use them now in this game? In this thing, you know, save those big plays, save those ups in games when they're going to need them, when they're going to have to face some intense pressure from, say, D.C. next weekend.
And this also, he's showing his versatility and his ability to kind of change his mindset the way he plays the game, which is really a great sign of a wonderful player, a guy with experience.
Well, as you age, you do have to adapt your game for different situations, and certainly coming back more often to handle when you've got young kids going up with you does make a lot of sense. When we saw Hunziker matched up again. Hunziker, we didn't get to talk about here. New York missing Quinn Hunziker, their star, out with the broken hand. Now, when we saw him matched up against Graham, just the difference there, man. Hunziker had the speed. He also had the ups. It'll make you feel like you need to come back to the disc more.
That's a good point. Hunziker is a terrific defensive player, and to see him out with that injury for the rest of the season certainly hurts the chances here for the Rumble. And you're missing Joe Anderson here today, who is really an inspirational player in that last win over Boston in that game played in New York. I think it was like May 5th or something like that.
Yeah, Anderson was big for them. He's out. You know, they lost in that one freak play we saw in Philadelphia. Milo Snyder, who was one of the defensive captains of this team last year, go out early, so he hasn't been around. So certainly the injury bug and the numbers are affecting this New York squad here.
New York looks like they're still full of fun on the sideline. And one of the things you need to do, despite losing or winning, is have fun. It looks like the Rumble coming out rather loose here in the second half, which could be good news. They're not coming out tight. You thought they were a little tight in the first half, first couple of possessions when they turned it over and set the tone.
I'm still surprised that they didn't recover from that midway through the half. I mean, you go down by five. Hey, maybe now you loosen up. But they stayed tight throughout that whole first half. Ultai Photos is the official photography partner of Major League Ultimate. Ultai Photos features an elite core of Ultimate photographers across the U.S. and Canada who are passionate about the sport of Ultimate. They are available to cover your Ultimate tournament and capture incredible photo memories for participants and fans. Check them out at www.ultaiphotos.com and check out their complete MLU game coverage at mluimages.com.
Those group of photographers are crazy. I mean, they're field level, right? They're down there. They get elbows dirty, knees dirty, down low. Great camera angles, great pictures.
And there's like two or three of them at every one of these games here. And they've got the whole lens package and They get great shots.
They really do.
There's a shot right there. Webster McBride and Anthony Nunez, the coaches of the New York Rumble in black there. Nunez, the head coach on the left. Webster McBride with the hat on the right. Wonder what they talked about at halftime.
Hold on to the disc, as you said. They really had problems.
Well, and again, they will start to receive here in the half, just like they did in the first half.
Well, they're down 13-4. Scoreboard is working off to our right. They probably just turn it off with a threat of lightning at the half. That's my guess. And save a little electricity.
Some dedicated fans here in Boston.
Absolutely.
Love to see this. They're all back here. I mean, it's cold rain, and they're all here.
Really nice crowd on hand for this one. Now New York to receive it. It will skid along the turf here at Hormel Stadium, and they'll quickly feed it up in the middle to Mr. Mazur.
Well, they run a Hostack here. Try to look for a downfield cutter. Get to behind Brownlee is the pass.
Yep. Saul try to feed it to him, and they come out, and they turn it right over again.
Chemistry an issue.
And Goldsmith off to the right. Is that because some guys might be playing out of position? We'll talk about that in a second. Did he make the grab? Will they rule it a catch? And the officials are going to converse momentarily. Foster, no. No catch. They turn it back. Thought there was a little conversation by the officials. Looked like he wanted to raise his arms there, that he had it. So New York again, trying to get something going. Some sort of flow here.
Well, they haven't gotten the deep looks to work. Uh-oh, count's getting up high on Murray again. Just gets it off.
Up to Saul. Isaac Saul spinning with it, and a little infraction there. A little bump. He'll get 10 free yards.
And take 15.
Now New York again. That's Herman.
Boy, Avery Cut is being tightly marked.
Yeah, Boston really has played a tight game. Almost a man-to-man defense with that's been a strangling defense, you'd have to call it. Brownlee.
I don't know. Brownlee trying to force one in there. Really not needed to Mazur. He needs to alter his delivery motion at some point there and just get a less arm movement and a quicker wrist.
Boston
delivery.
Flowed a lot of players through that passing lane, too. Now they're trying to cash in at the other end. Is McDonald holding, looking. Brownlee back there defensively. Roth outright. Yep. And here's a drop.
Well, slippery conditions now. The rain has slowed, but the field, as you can see, is damp. The disc as well.
Alexander Trahey couldn't hold on to that disc. There's a long huck. Brownlee behind the defense. That's going to hang up there. Brownlee will make the catch. In for the score for New York.
Well, they needed that. Beautiful put there. Way to float it up into the stratosphere as it comes down easily, nicely to Brownlee, who beat his man deep for the goal.
Well, New York needed that.
Yes, they did. I like that they're putting it deep like that, too, because certainly the under looks aren't working. I think that might have been Murray with the release.
Yeah.
Nice touch. Brownlee makes sure to go up with two hands to get it. And gets it in the bread basket.
2:13 into the third quarter of play, and it's 13-5. We get the New York pull, Boston, with their O-line players out there. See Jeff Graham. We talk so much about Jeff and what he has meant to this Boston Whitecap team and the sport overall.
Well, he's been the captain of a lot of teams. Actually, the Brusher with the disc there and Jeff Graham both went to UMass Amherst, also a team that played at College Nationals this week, and they were eliminated, however, earlier today.
Brusher and Rebholz playing some catch. Now it's Jimmy Foster. They work the sideline. That's Graham. Back goes Joshua Marquette. Cricket plays it all the way cross field near side. That's Marquette now with it.
Well, they used that field nicely.
Far side. Yeah, didn't they?
Yeah.
Pressure's made some nice throws today.
Yeah, he's big for these guys. He was missing last week.
And some nice catches. Did he hold it?
No
he didn't, unfortunately.
Can't quite get to it.
This is Murphy. Whoa. And there's some D. Wow.
Ingold Smith with the run through, it looks like.
Yeah, he's off to the racers. Did a nice job.
He's good for one of those games. That's no doubt. He's a top defender here on this team.
Pressure will play it on back. Reb Holtz. A nice reaching catch near side by Gesu. Malachek. And nice touch for the catch in for the score. Was that Jimmy Foster who made that nice play? It was.
Yeah, Foster. Again, he releases nice those backhands. I mean, you got to know that he's getting those.
It's classic, isn't it?
Yeah. Old school. You're right. So is that Foster, we think, with the run through D? Yeah.
Yep.
So bookends for Jim Foster. Foster, a Madison, UW-Madison graduate. And his team will face, let's see who they face in the quarterfinals tomorrow morning, Don. Looks like it's going to be Michigan versus Colorado. This is all the men's. The women's also, of course, have played Texas versus Oregon. Wisconsin, the 12 seed, against UNC Chapel Hill. North Carolina, the 6 seed. And UNCW, North Carolina Wilmington, will face number 2, Pittsburgh, who, as we know, has several players from that team who will be joining the Spinners in a few weeks when Nationals has ended.
We saw a preview with a couple of those players a couple weeks ago, didn't we?
Marcus Rainey, Jottrow, Max Thorns, big names out there will be joining Philadelphia shortly.
You see, the flight of that disc was interesting. Reb Holtz, I should say, that was Hennessy over to Mazur. Reb Holtz gets it back. I should say Hennessy gets it back. Look at the wrong roster. This is Brownlee up ahead. Hennessy with a running catch here.
Awesome. Tough D still here from, there it is, too.
And Goldsmith with a defensive play. He got hurt, too. Mazur knows it. That was kind of an awkward fall into him, and hopefully he's okay. It was his shoulder. Chris Mazur probably heard the pop. That's my guess.
Well, I hope not.
Indeed.
He's holding it. I hope it's just a stinger. He makes the nice layout here, though, and hits awkwardly. You're right. No, he just kind of got rolled over on it a little bit there. Wow.
Chris Mazur showing the concern, the sportsman he is. He's going to be all right, I think.
I hope so.
Yeah.
These things are always a little bit scary. You don't want to tear a labrum or something.
Mr. Ingold Smith has had himself quite a game today. This is Cooper now. Malachek. Much better effort today versus the last time they played New York. He has really been terrific.
Well, you can't keep a good man down for long, that's for sure. He's just too good of a player. He'll have a bad game, sure, but he won't have that many.
Heath to the near side. Cooper will deliver, and there's a score. On the receiving end, Christian Foster.
Well, textbook offense there. Swing it to one side, and then you're looking for that umbrella cut to the end zone. And Cooper, with a quick release, finds his man, and Herman, not enough time. Look, he releases that right in stride there. Just kind of like a waiter serving up there to his man, Christian Foster, for the goal.
That's the fourth throw for a score by Cooper today.
Yeah, Cooper's really been playing well. Thomas Alex Cooper, who told me he'll be going back to New York tonight for Memorial Day, as his family and he are from the Westchester area there.
Yeah, nice about the Saturday game here. Still get a chance to get home and enjoy Sunday and Monday with your family.
Cooper, a man I've played competitively with in the summer league down in New York. He's a lot of fun because he's a great thrower, just a great athlete. And you see him today, you said 5 assists already. I mean, he just knows how to find the end zone.
So the Rumble. I was reading an interesting article on the MLU page talking about the Poles and defenses not getting downfield until there's 2 or 3, maybe 4 tosses. And that's kind of an example of that right there, a shorter toss. Yeah, they're going to go nice for part. It all here, and that's just going to run out of real estate.
Oh, I thought that might have been a nice Brendan look Ryan. There, but yeah, just a little too long.
Rain continues to fall.
He's going to take it from where it went out of bounds. So Hard's disc there didn't make it too far as some yards Boston to start.
Cricket Marquette will play it on back. Henry Pressure. He's all over the field today. The Reb Holtz kind of stumbled to a stop.
Well, there's no reason to do anything risky here.
Boston content just to make some accurate passes.
Yeah.
They have the lead. Montgomery Butler wears number 14.
The thing that's great about this team is they will put it at any given time if the shot's there, though. They're not afraid to send it, and that's what makes them so dangerous.
Yeah, Banerjee. Nice D.
Yeah, Banerjee comes on under, distracts McDonald from the disc there. Not sure Banerjee got a piece, but he gets the credit for the D.
Murphy throws it low. They have lived on the edge with every throw today, have the Rumble. Let's see if they can cash in. Hardens will lay it up there. Saul on the run will make the catch for the score. That's Saul? Yeah, indeed.
It's Baum. No, Matt no, Baum there from so Brenton Hard.
15 with the goal.
So finally, Hart finds the end zone here. We're going to watch the D from Banerjee there as he comes under nicely. Just plays the under perfectly. And just an out cut here. Nice touch there from Brent Hard after the first pass he threw that direction. Crashed down to the ground a little too early and sailed out of bounds. So this one he puts Lallaire under and the score for Baum.
So that will make it 15-6 with 3:28 remaining. Thought it was Saul. Saul doesn't catch many for score, though, does he? He likes to throw it. He wears 19. Well, I'm wearing 15, of course, for New York. Now the pull. Mitch has been handling that duty all day today. Malachek in the middle. Brownlee's been trying to match up with him all day long. It's been tough for him.
Well, it was fun when Anderson was on him with the long arms mm-hmm. that Anderson Whoa. Has.
Oh. That one handcuffed off a little bit.
Yeah, came across, he had to turn his body around. Just the angle, difficult for Roth to read.
This is Saul. Feeds the sideline.
Chance for New York to break here.
Andrew Bosco.
Ooh.
Oh, there's some defense. No contact. Farnsworth. Haven't called his name all that often today. Comes up with a beautiful play.
Well, he's matched up there on Mazur. Mazur scrambling to try to get open as they know they need him. And Farnsworth with the assignment to shut down Mazur gets one on him right there with the layout D. Nicely done.
They were just bumping each other there towards midfield a little bit.
Jockeying for position, absolutely. Yeah. And Farnsworth got the inside track. Oh.
That's blocked by Mazur. He may really didn't have enough space there.
Yeah. Now he's got to rush to catch back up because as soon as this disc comes to the 10 yards, it's back in. Yeah. And gets there in time.
Cooper, near side. Marquette, the feed, and in for the score. More points up on the board as once again Boston, they're down the field and they tally. I believe that was number four. Five, wasn't it? Sean Doherty on the receiving end.
Well, I'm just not sure why New York doesn't do something, anything. Play some zone, switch things up. I mean, they haven't played a lot of zone. Obviously, the issues are on the O. But, maybe a zone can get them some easy scores, some quick scores, anything at this point. But score is 16-6. Breakmark is an official merchandiser of the MLU, providing gear for all MLU officials and producing the official headwear of the league. A lot of hats out there, you see. Breakmark from Boston here produces high-quality custom ultimate gear for high school, college, and club teams. Look for them at breakmark.com for all your ultimate apparel needs.
Boston with a pull from left to right, leading by 10. This game really started out in their favor, 7-1. First quarter lead. It took 9 minutes and some 29 seconds before the Rumble put up their first goal.
This is just one of those forget about it games in New York.
Yeah, really, it is.
Happened last year in the West Coast. I think there was something like a 25-10.
More defense by Boston.
That's your man.
Be impressed.
Is that your man Stevens?
I think it is.
That was a nice D there. Cuts across the bottom.
See how talented he is. He can under. Do it all.
He's a quick player. He's always been out of Bridgewater State there.
Rep Holtz.
You've done any Bridgewater State?
No, no games? Bridgewater State games. I'll be there for track presented by the MIAA, the high school authorities here in Massachusetts in a few weeks. So I'll get at least to see the facility. I mean, I'll be there to see the facility at Bridgewater. Rep Holtz, sideline.
Wow, even had an open man there.
It was Heath. Love the way they reverse that disc.
Yeah, and they've got a cut every time they do that to the cone there. So you've seen what Boston's running here now, which is try to reverse the disc. And our pregame kind of like keys to the game were, you know, get Boston out of that rhythm, get them to higher stall counts, and, you know, New York not able to do that right now. Which means you got to jump some of those unders and then, you know, force them to try to go through the middle of the field instead of using the sidelines like they do so effectively.
And Goldsmith back into the game. That's great news.
Yes, that is.
He was banged up earlier. Rep Holtz.
See, it's so. And then he sets that up. Beautifully set up.
And my man couldn't come up with it, Eric Stevens, that time. Off his hands.
So I don't know if you can see this on your screen, folks, but he sets this up now. It's the same corner that they've been shooting all their goals to. And you think, well, why doesn't the defender get there? Well, I'll tell you why. Stevens, at the 10-yard mark around there, cuts back, and it looks like he does a juke that looks like he's going to go to the middle of the field. I don't know why New York is buying this all the time, but every team gets suckered into this. You know, it's pretty common. And then he goes out. So it's the juke and the setup of your cut that's getting these wide-open looks for Boston all game long.
Rumble will get it back here.
Only got 11 seconds here. Full field. Chance to try to score before the end of the quarter.
Lucas Murphy. Ready, camera two. He'll dump it back.
Oh, you need a play call here with 11 seconds, not a bunch of handling.
Tennessee. Near side.
Well, now they send. No, not even now.
I don't know if they're going to have time to get it downfield here. Tennessee double teamed. Oh, 2 seconds remaining in the quarter.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I see. Our clock is wrong. Yeah. There's 18 seconds left now. Sorry about that, folks. I can see the stadium clock now with 11, 10, 9. And now they got to start looking end zone.
And got a whistle. Had some contact. Horn will sound. How the official is going to call this. I think we're going to see another throw.
I think you're right. I think you might have got him on the arm.
Yeah.
Although we see a Boston guy running downfield. Is that Graham? I'm not sure what Graham's doing right now.
Maybe they're going to award it to the Whitecaps.
I think they're going to.
Offensive foul, change of possession, right?
Wow. Could be right. We'll see where Rep Holtz walks this disc back up to. If he's up at the spot of the foul, then we'll know. It looks like it is. He's not taking it down the line there. So this could be. Just add to the woes of the Rumble right now.
Mad Rep Holtz.
Did Rep Holtz also go to Wisconsin? These guys are living the life. Yeah, another Wisconsin player. You know why that team's always in the hunt for the national title now.
Look at this. They're getting that disc towards midfield, too.
And who was the first to recognize that? Jeff Graham. Smart player.
They're going to double team Rep Holtz here.
Try to get it out of his hands so he doesn't have the chance to shoot in the end zone. But 10 seconds is a lot of time.
They put 10 seconds on that clock.
Right, here's the throw to the end zone.
Again, into a crowd, and that's going to be plucked away. So the defense comes up big, and the horn will sound, and no chance for the Rumble to transition offensively. Through three quarters, Boston on top, 16-6 over New York. We'll take a break. Back with the fourth quarter right after this.
Come on out and bring the family when the Boston Whitecaps come to Sweeney Field at St. Joe's University to take on the Philadelphia Spinners. Go to spinnerstix.com and grab a four-pack for just $44. Join us for games, prizes, and ultimate fun for the whole family. June 15th at 2 p.m. Tickets are on sale now.
Right back here at Hormel Stadium through three, Boston 16, New York 6. Rather evenly played third quarter, Tony. I know there's a lot of activity and a lot of folks that help out the MLU.
Well, let's talk about the MLU shop. First of all, you can get some good gear there. MLU Live 10 will get you a 10% discount. That's MLULIVE, the number 1010 at MLUShop.com to save on shirts, hats, discs, socks, gloves, and more.
Maybe they should sell umbrellas.
They might sell those.
Yeah.
Well, the socks, I've talked about the socks. I can't talk enough about the socks. I love the socks. Let's see what else on there. The hats,
nothing
the
like
discs.
Great sock talk, too. That's good stuff.
Some good sock talk. I got a disc. The disc is really nice.
Yep.
I do have a shirt. The shirt's nice. I can't speak for the gloves yet or the hats. I'll have to cross those off.
I played some disc golf, whatever you want to call it, the other day.
Yeah,
in the backyard, so it really...
You might call it frolf, but others do say disc golf. Yeah.
Disc golf, yeah.
In the backyard.
In the backyard.
Wow.
Well, it was a short game we played.
Putting. You're putting.
I didn't realize the nuances or the differences in the putting disc and the driving disc and the variety of discs, the mid-range disc.
You know who's masterful at making those different discs, which do have different flight trajectories and length, and they're very different. They're all approximately the same, but Innova, who makes the Pulsar that we play with
right
now.
That's what they were.
That's what they started with and continued to have much success in the disc golf arena and really broke into Ultimate here with that Pulsar.
Did not have the netting, the golf net.
Yeah,
we improvised.
Did you use a tree or a fire hydrant?
We use a tire.
A tire?
Yeah, a tire.
You sure this wasn't like a flashback from the 70s, Don?
No, I think it was last week.
I think it was last. We were throwing frisbees into a tire.
16-6, 10 left.
Well, these guys are smiling. Look, they're laughing at our jokes there.
Yeah, they
There's the Farnsworth thinks it's funny.
What are you saying? I'm going to go play some golf.
I'm going to play some frolf afterwards.
I didn't realize that all these free courses that are all over the place.
Yeah,
too,
it's actually
amazing.
Very well set up across the nation.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pro. There's a pro circuit, an amateur circuit, a pro-am circuit, male and female and stuff. There's a lot of action with it.
Yeah, my nephew plays. He's trying to turn me on to the game. So I'm going to look for some of those public courses, I guess you'd call them, in Connecticut.
It's fun because you get to see the, you know, you can travel anywhere and get to a good disc golf course.
So just underway here in the fourth, Malachek. A lot of different guys touching that disc today for Boston. Farnsworth seeing more time here as this game moves along.
Well, here's New York in a matchup zone. As you can see, something went a little bit weird there. They're playing a little poachy, trying to mix it up.
Yeah, they need the disc, obviously. Down by 10.
Yeah, and time. They need to get quick turnovers. Oh, there's one for them.
Exactly. Ebholz just couldn't scoop that one up on a low throw.
And now where the legs come in play here, you see one man going downfield here, but they need more than that.
Austin Raymond. Somebody got a ban. Was it Raymond or?
It was Banerjee with the disc
Banerjee
right here.
Okay.
We were discussing that in the break as to try to find out what he might have said to earn the orange band he's wearing there.
Don't want to wear that band.
Now, last game we saw Marquette get
there
for having a few words when a Philadelphia player stepped into their huddle towards the end of that crazy game when it was 25-24. Boston with a chance to score at the end there.
That was entertaining.
Looks like some more words being said here.
Looked like Graham and Matt Hennessy.
Yeah. as Coach Rosenthal steps between them. Hennessy not known as a firebrand. Neither is Graham. Both good-spirited fellows. Not sure there's any call here, but some discussion. Game could be getting chippy here. You mentioned the Bruins earlier.
Yeah, right. See some parallels to the game of hockey.
Oh, that would be the day, but I doubt that would happen.
No, that would.
Certainly, New York's got to show a little grit, though. Just, you know, you can't appreciate getting beaten like you are now.
To the sideline, Marquette. He'll hammer that one along. Beautiful throw. Stevens, Farnsworth. See, Farnsworth would be the muscle guy you'd have out there if it turned more hockey-ish.
I would take Malachek.
Would you? Yeah. You know what? He looks strong.
And he's got that Czech last name. Doesn't that sound like kind of Czech?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
They play hockey.
Never thought of it that way. They score again as Boston puts up yet another one, and they lead it 17. Foster, he's had himself a nice day today.
Not happy there with Banerjee is Foster. Emphatic spike of the disc after he gets Banerjee on the side cut there. Here's this setup again there. He's wide open across the field. They scored a ton of goals there. Turns, tells his team he's still into this game here as Boston with the commanding lead at 17-6.
That's his second goal for Foster today.
Elemental Technologies is one of the main reasons we are able to bring you this game live. It's our partner, Elemental Technologies. Elemental is the leading supplier of video solutions for multi-screen content delivery, providing unmatched solutions for more than 250 leading media franchises worldwide. Elemental helps pay TV operators, content programmers, film studios, and sports broadcasters bring video to any screen, anytime, all at once. To learn more, visit elementaltechnologies.com or follow Elemental Tech on Twitter.
So the Rumble again. Mazur.
Well, we haven't seen a Mazur huck for a completion big time yet. See if they try to set up something for him to get some looks downfield.
Interesting statement. I wonder how many tosses over 40 yards they've completed here today.
I don't know. They had
maybe
some.
One, right?
Whoa.
That was kind of a lucky catch. Mazur just caught that right off the back of the defender in Cole Smith. And now they turn it over.
Don, whoa. You know.
Mazur, what a fake there by in Cole Smith.
Yeah. It's got Mazur to fall down in anticipation of trying to get that hope to get that disc back. Oh, a little trip there. Got to call a foul there as Mazur bodied up Ingold Smith.
Mazur has been all over the field trying to get his team
trying
home.
To do anything he can, really. But in terms of the deep looks, you know, you typically get a couple of shots early in the game, and when you see the receiver can't come down with it, here's a big hammer chance. Yeah. Hung it.
There's a whistle, and would he make the catch? Hey, he did. Ingold Smith, we thought he was banged up, but they may wave this off. I don't know. I thought I heard a whistle downfield, and they're going to call it all back. I think Saul had not given enough room to the thrower.
Fantastic, Scott, nonetheless, from Ingold Smith. That's a continuation in USAU, but here this will come back. Watch Montgomery Butler. Looks like it's a clean look everywhere. Yeah. Not sure where the call is. This is an offensive foul. As the disc will come back. So it might have been on a cut setup, a downfield cutter. Might have had a position fail. Oh,
nice catch
Ingold
there.
Smith is enjoying the turf here, the rain conditions.
Put him in the circus the way he's making those catches today. And we get another whistle. Was that a stall? That couldn't be a stall count, was it?
Well, the disc will go back to New York and Mazur. Double teamed. Finds the open man.
Saul to the near side here. They give him a little space.
Boy, he's got those pirouette motions on his release to Saul, doesn't he?
Mm-hmm. Saul, that was going to sky a little bit. Murray couldn't come up with it. You know, Murray came in struggling to catch the disc. It's continued here today. Even though that one kind of floated on him a little bit. And Goldsmith awaits, floats down. Saul trying to play some defense. Goldsmith the catch, and it's in for the score. As Christian Foster will grab it.
Bodies hit the turf here. Everyone flying around on the The surface, which should be fine, will hold this water just fine, so no concerns about that. But it's getting a little tired, a little late in the game here. Here's the pass that gets caught by Mazur with a quick reaction. Here's Ingold Smith with the fake that gets Mazur to the ground. And Ingold Smith again diving. Made the fantastic hammer catch. Doesn't get that in the books, but gets this catch and then throws the goal right after, right here. Boom, nice and easy.
Boy, that was a sequence of plays. Highlight reel.
It's a one-man highlight reel,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Rusty Ingold Smith there.
Seconds.
From, well, his team also, I believe, see if I get this right here. I think he's a UNCW fella is what I think. Yeah, UNC Wilmington. So another man who's alumni. He's an alumnus of the University of North Carolina Wilmington who will be playing tomorrow in the quarterfinals at the national championships in college.
Ward out to the right. Let's see if New York, I think it's become a broken record statement. Let's see if New York can.
Ooh.
And they can't. Walter nearly with a dramatic catch. Pounded his fist into the turf. That was a tough play.
That's a travel right there, but not called.
Down the field, and the defense is made. Good work there by Austin Raymond. Pass might have been a little bit underthrown, and Raymond able to bat it down.
Still a good, great play as he was able to turn his body around, because if he didn't, Foster was there to catch it.
Just about 5 minutes remaining here. Evan Walter. Banerjee's had some interesting moments playing with that band today. We see that here in the second half here. Rain continues to fall the entire second half.
Ooh.
And trying to make the catch was Matt Hennessy. Just couldn't haul it in with the left hand.
Well, this is the game that will question your soul at the end of it. Really tough for New York right now. Nothing going their way. It's raining on them. They're hitting the ground. Every pass is just out of their reach. Really frustrating. It's got to be for some of the players out there.
Good 3.5 hour ride home. Maybe four.
Four and a half.
Four and a half. Maybe five.
No, it won't be that bad.
There's a nice play again by Matthew McDonald Rowan. He's like the unsung hero, and he'll cash in with the catch right there. He's on the stat sheet.
Well, the young legs and McDonald get it done there as he streaks downfield as the fast break off the turnover in the end zone from New York allows Boston to streak down the field. And, well, I think the record is about to be set here for lowest points scored in the MLU. That's for sure. I believe, again, we talked about this. I believe it was a 25-10 score last year. So 10 points, and not sure New York will get there, but they will have 4 minutes left.
Of course, a loss is a loss. Doesn't matter if you lose by one or 25 in the long run. But
yeah. And this wasn't a game they were expected to win.
No.
Boston's undefeated here at home.
That's right.
Yeah. And New York will have one more shot at them.
Yeah, they will. Boston went on a 6-0 run to start this game, and they have now gone on a four-goal run here from the late third quarter to the fourth quarter.
So you saw Mazur there talking about who's going to start the playoff. So starts it off to Mazur.
Mazur's going to huck one. We haven't seen many of those. Looking for Brownlee, and that one got away. Looked like he may have slipped out of his hand.
Well, they did try the deep look. Had Brownlee streaking and open. Mazur has the range, but the rain may be a factor. Innova is the official disc of the MLU. It's also the Innova Pulsar, specifically. Designed in cooperation with players and staff of the MLU, the new Pulsar is the perfect disc for the pro game. Get your Pulsar today at shop.mluultimate.com or visit innovadiscs.com.
Whitecaps looking for more little floater, and it's caught on the run. Rusty Ingold Smith had himself a game here today in a little celebration.
Nicely done. Rusty Ingold Smith getting the recognition he's well deserved as he's showing everything he's got here in the rainy conditions. Still second his team up. See him calling out He said, let's go D. Brusher feeds him.
I guess he likes the rain.
I guess so. Normally, New NCW is a beach town, so they like the beach, the surf, the wind, and the rain.
Mentioned Brusher. He's had a couple of great throws today, in particular in the first half. So 20-6, 3:17 remaining in the fourth quarter.
Well, you know, you asked earlier whether Boston would let up, and, you know, it's not like they're, I don't know. I think they're playing pretty hard, so I guess the answer would be no. We saw Foster earlier. We've seen Rusty. He doesn't look like he's like it's a 20-6 game at all, the way he's playing.
They're sticking to their game plan.
Yeah. So they play hard no matter the score.
And they want to preserve everything that they earn here at home, that when you come here to this home field, you're in for a big battle. We're not letting up on you.
Well, so the big game is next week when they play D.C. here. 2 weeks from now. You know, I talked to assistant coach Tom Matthews. I said, well, you guys are at 3-3. You're two games behind. You know, what do you do? What do you have to do? And he said, we got to win out.
Yeah.
So they got to win out, and they got to get a loss from D.C. along the way, because even if they win out and D.C. loses to Boston but wins the rest, they will still have to play D.C. at D.C. So right now they're talking home field advantage. But this is a good way to let people know, yeah, you come here, you're in for a beatdown. A beatdown in Beantown.
That's right. No, it's perfect. It's perfect.
Or Medford.
Just above 2 minutes remaining. Oops there, and New York will get it back.
Nice fake there.
I'd like to see one good foray down the field here by... Well, not going to see it there. Again, they turn it over. That's been the story of the game today. And that's an easy grab. Now a check on the receiving end.
Well, frustration continues for New York. There's our man Malachek there, collects the goal. He looks a little bit winded, but not too bad to make it through four quarters in these conditions and still have a little bit left in the tank there. New York certainly winded with only 14 guys up here. So Malachek there is putting the game, the numbers up, and he'll get to enjoy tomorrow. And, you know, maybe get
That's
to
right.
watch his Wisconsin boys go to battle.
If you just put together the first and fourth quarters, Tony, Boston has outscored New York now 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12-1.
12-1 in the first and the fourth, yeah. Well, they're a good team at the start and a good team at
the
finish.
At the end, absolutely. No argument here. Great thing about today's game, too, the enthusiasm of the crowd despite the weather, although it looks like the rain has subsided here, which is maybe what they're cheering about right now, but they've hung in all day.
Yeah, they're all here.
Yes, they are. They have not left that great youth clinic they put together earlier today.
Look at that slide by Mazur. It's fun to slide on that damp turf.
I think you could safely say before just about everybody's home game, they put on a beautiful youth clinic and get the youngsters involved from the surrounding communities, which is great for the sport.
Yeah, you know, and it just it shows also when you get to watch a game that you can make great athletic plays and get cheered on by people, because every ultimate athlete knows that, you know, a lot of times you play on fields far away and you just don't get that support and the recognition that they deserve. It's all athletes out here.
And a little example of some athleticism right there on a nice catch by number 37, Matthew Heath. Okay. Yeah. I'd like to see them make that top line and the seven just a little longer. 22-7 is
scored. Guess you threw that, Don. Ingold Smith, it looked like, put that up. I saw a little flash of purple on the shoelaces.
So Heath on the scoreboard here.
So the over-under in this game was somewhere around 3, 4, 16.
Look, I got a question for you. Call me crazy.
Yeah.
These white cap uniforms, for some reason, make me think of the Philadelphia Spinners of a year ago. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is.
Don, I think you've just got yourself hired as the uniform director for 2015. I'm going to do some design work on the side.
Yeah, we need some design work. Yeah. They stole something. I don't know. Maybe
you think they stole it?
No, they didn't steal it.
They probably borrowed it.
They wouldn't do that. Borrowed. I like that.
Well, New York playing for pride on this point.
Let's see if they can put it together again. I'll tell you what. Let's tip a cap to the Whitecaps, too. They have just played a complete game here today. They could have easily backed off. They haven't. Mr. Roth with some defense.
Yeah, you can talk about New York's ills all you want, but obviously New York, Boston, a fantastic team with a trove of athleticism, and they're really showing it here.
Yeah, Zid. Another touch.
A wide open man downfield.
Cooper, look at that, Chuck. You said he could throw it. Oh, and the catch is made. Roth on the receiving end. Actually, Marquette on the receiving end. There you go.
Well, Matt Hennessy can't believe it. He thought he had that read nicely. He even slowed it up a little bit there. And Cooper just gets enough of it over his head. There it is on the quick release. He saw, you know, Matt Hennessy read this nice. Yep. Goes up. And, oh, man. Just out of his reach. The whole game has been like that for New York, where you think you got an easy one. You hold up for it. Just goes over your head like that.
I think that was thrown on a string.
Yeah. Sure looked like it. Ah, now you see it. Ah, now you don't. Out of your reach. Well, there's a happy Boston Whitecaps squad, despite the rain. Marquette there, Malachek. Foster walks past us. Miles Montgomery Butler in the middle there. There's Alex Cooper, number 8, celebrating another score.
With the win, Boston will improve to 4-3. New York's going to drop to 2-5.
Well, let's talk about the standings a little bit. Yeah, so D.C. current with a 2-game lead here in the East. And the Spinners and the New York Rumble at the bottom looking to try to find a way into the playoffs.
Time ticking down. Walter with a long huck. It's going to hang up there. And will it be caught by anybody? It's going to be intercepted. What else is new as this game will end? Nice play by Heath on the intercept on a Hail Mary.
Yeah, all Boston all the way in this one as the final score, 23-6, reflective of the game.
We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. We'll wrap things up here and have our post-game show for you. Right here on MLU Live, your final, Boston 23, New York 6.
Brendan Wong hopes to continue his scoring frenzy as the Nighthawks fly south to Seattle, but Donnie Clark and the potent Rainmaker offense stand in their way. Come out and bring the family May 31st at 7 p.m. Evan Boucher and the Dogfish hope to stay in the playoff hunt when they travel north to Portland, but Eli Friedman and the Stags try to get their season back on track. San Francisco at Portland, May 31st at 6 p.m.
Right back here at Hormel Stadium, a convincing win for Boston. They win their fourth of the year, 23-6 over New York. They lose their fifth of the season, Tony. And really, Rusty and Goldsmith exemplified what Boston Whitecap character is all about.
Well, and that means playing to the end of the game, playing hard, putting your body on the line no matter the score, and just, you know, being darn good. So our player of the game from the booth here, we want to call it out to Rusty Ingold Smith for being fabulous out there and racking up the goals and the assists. Here's a little highlight reel for your game here as he goes up and catches that hammer over him. Mazer, the layout bid there makes it look easy, but boy, he's full extension. This is like an easy catch for Rusty Ingold Smith. Man on his back, goes up with the left hand, throws the goal. Hey, why not? Day in the park.
Just a continuation of play. Like you said, a walk in the park. On Memorial Day weekend, we do wish you a safe and happy Memorial Day weekend. There's your final score, Boston over New York, 23-6. But Tony Leonardo, great work as always.
Don,
I'm Don
Roger.
Boyle. The entire crew, behind the scenes, good work on MLU Live. That's going to do it from Hormel Stadium. Goodbye, everybody.